Chief Kehinde, and I will be presenting on the oath. This is what we will be covering in my presentation today. We will be covering vocabulary, background, history, symptoms, diagnosis, treatment, the main vector of yellow fever in third world countries, vaccines, prevention, and then I'll have my talk. Some vocabulary that you will see in my presentation today is a zoonosis, or a disease transmitted between species, airborne, something that is transported by air, outbreak, the sudden or violent start of something unwelcome, such as war, but in my case, or in the case of my presentation, a disease, vector, a mosquito or a tick that carries a disease. We'll also have viral, or something caused by a virus relating to, or typical of a virus, physiotropic, a disease having to do with organs in the abdominal cavity, and endemic, something regularly found among particular people in a certain area. All right, we're gonna start with the background. What is yellow fever? Yellow fever is a fatal infectious disease, often viral and found in warm climates. It is carried by the Aedes aegypti mosquito and is a microbe found in the variant of that one. It is zoonotic and is an acute systemic disease, meaning that it affects on the organs in the body. And this is a picture of a yellow fever microbe bacteria. Now looking at my history. The first evidence of yellow fever was found during the 17th century by a U.S. public service health physician, Henry Rose Carter. The evidence he found was a Mayan writing from Yucatan. In the 18th and 19th century, there were outbreaks in the Americas and in West Africa because of the major seaports found in those areas. In 1793, there was an outbreak in Philadelphia, causing 10% of the population to decrease. In 1878, there were outbreaks in the Mississippi Valley causing 20,000 people to die. And this is a picture of Henry Rose Carter. At first, it was thought to be airborne, and Benjamin Rush, the first learned physician at that time, had also supported that theory as well. But because that couldn't be proven, they couldn't exactly come up with a vaccine for yellow fever at the time. Symptoms. Alright, there are two phases of symptoms for yellow fever. There's phase one and there's phase two. In phase one, symptoms tend to last for a shorter duration of time. So then these are symptoms: fever, muscle pain, backache, headache, shivers, loss of appetite, nausea, and vomiting. Alright, phase two. 15% of patients enter this phase within 24 hours of remission. In phase one, that lasts from 3 to 4 days, and then there's a time of like you're fine. And 15% of the patients that enter that remission phase end up in phase two, which consists of jaundice, or the yellowing of the whites of the eyes, or yellowing of the skin, abdominal pains, vomiting, bleeding from the mouth, nose, eyes, or stomach, blood found in vomit and feces, and kidney function deteriorates. Alright, technique of diagnosis. Yellow fever can be difficult to diagnose because it can be confused with diseases such as severe malaria, dengue, hemorrhagic fever, leptospirosis, viral hepatitis forms B and D, and even poisoning. Blood tests can detect yellow fever in response of yellow fever antibodies produced in response to the infection. And here is a diagram of what would happen. So it says that the tourniquet or a device used to stop bleeding is applied and the area is disinfected, and then the needle is introduced into the vein and blood is drawn into the lab to be analyzed. And for this to happen, you have to have a very highly trained laboratory staff and special equipment and materials. Treatment. There is no specific treatment for yellow fever while you have the disease. Bacterial infections that are associated with yellow fever can be treated with antibiotics, and supportive care may improve outcomes for seriously ill patients. Supportive care may be able to treat dehydration, respiratory failure, and fever. Great, the main vector of yellow fever. Main vector of yellow fever is the Aedes aegypti mosquito. It survives year-round in tropical environments, prefers humans, and is the most active part of the day, 2 hours after sunrise, and a few hours before dusk. The Aedes aegypti mosquito carries other diseases, and the female mosquito uses the blood for reproduction. The female mosquito needs supplemental substances found in the blood, such as protein and iron, to develop eggs. So basically, our blood is a fuel for creating eggs. The Aedes aegypti mosquito is one of the easiest species of mosquitoes to contain in the lab. Therefore, we have a lot of information about this mosquito. And here's a picture of the Aedes aegypti mosquito. Great. Yellow fever in third world countries. There are many cases of yellow fever found in Africa and South America. Over 39 years, there were 33,000 total cases combined. In these countries, it's hard to count and manage the amount of cases there actually are, so sometimes the information that we receive might be faulty, because in Africa, the cases can range from 1 to 5,000 cases, which is a huge range. And here it shows the yellow fever endemic zones. You can see, like, in Africa, you know, most of the waters are like the seaports, bottom up for it. And even here, it's pretty close. All right, vaccines. Called the YFVax. It's an affordable vaccine. 95% of people that took this vaccine got immunity against the YF in 7 to 10 days. A single dose is sufficient for a long time, for lifelong immunity, so you take it once and you're immune to it. Side effects are rare, but in the elderly, so like people like 60 and above, they might have some respiratory diseases, like a list for that. A booster dose for yellow fever is not needed, because once you get it, you have immunity. But the single, like the most important thing that you should do though is get the vaccine. And here is what it would look like. Prevention. Prevention is to use insect repellent, like EPA registered insect repellent, wear proper clothing, wear long pants and shirts if the weather permits. Mosquitoes can bite through thin clothing, so you might want to spray your clothes with insect repellent. You have to be aware of mosquito allergies, and of course, to also get vaccinated. All right, here's one of the bibliography. I want to acknowledge God, Dr. Williams, Dr. Nim, Mr. Robinson, Mr. Slough, my classmates, my family, and my presentation support team, Carson, Donovan, and Ms. Law. Any comments, questions, or constructive criticism? Some of them will cover and have little to no origin. Pardon?
So how long does the vaccine last?
The vaccine lasts throughout your life.
Can you go back to said that this carries other diseases, so you think it can?
It cures other diseases?
Oh, carries.
Oh, such as like dengue fever?
Phew. Were there any major epidemics, like what years were it?
There were epidemics in Philadelphia and Mississippi. The exact year, 1793, 1870. Who's left?
Is there any current or future research going on with the yellow fever?
Well, there is some future research. They're trying to figure out a way to have places like the third world countries, like in Africa, in Latin America. They're trying to like manage the mosquitoes, or somehow find a way to get at least 60 to 80% of the population vaccinated, so that we won't have serious outbreaks as they did in the past.
What are some ways that they can widespread the manage mosquitoes?
They talked a lot about like the way people like the water. They said that mosquitoes are drawn to like moist places. So they're saying that